Good afternoon. I'm Dork Mistress here with Holly, and you're watching the 2017 International Wftda Division 1 Playoffs live from Malmö, Sweden. Brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Crime City Rollers. This afternoon, we're going to see Gotham All-Stars taking on Detroit All-Stars. Gotham is from New York, and they're coming into the tournament in the number one seed and are currently ranked 3 in the Wftda. Detroit and are from Detroit, and they are entering this playoff the number 8 seed and are ranked 22 in the Wftda. And now for our team rosters. Gotham roster, we have 010 Giles, 06 Shortstop, 1680 Daryl, 17 Fast and Loose, 1706 Misty Rate Maven, 18 V Diva, 1978 Space Invader, 314 Caffeine, 4 Violet Knockout, 41 Roxy Dallas, 4500 Benita Apple Bomb, 68 Sexy Slady, 7 Brazilian Nut, 999 Puss and Glute, 137 Big Banger, and 23 Livy Smalls.
Thank you, Dork Mistress. And moving on to Detroit Roller Derby's All-Stars. We have 08, Gillian Ricard. Number 10, Swift Justice. Number 14, Oi Rish, who is the captain today. Number 1968, Julie Ruin. Number 241, Lollipop Some Hard. Number 28, Racer McChaser. Number 31, Terrorettes. Number 32, McDonald. Number 33, Cookie Rumble. Number 40, Kelly Janai. Number 45, Fetus Lees. Number 620, Laserbeam. Number 66, Parrish. Number 989, Sarah Hippel. We are straight into the action. We've got Sarah Hippel up against Misty Maven. Misty Maven pushing on that inside, looking for that outside sweep, takes a hit whip, but gets clustered up with the Detroit. Detroit playing in white, Gotham playing in the black. A good hit whip around the outside, but a knocked out, recycled back on Misty Maven.
It's taken 20 seconds for the packs to fall into two walls, and that's when the lead jammer comes through.
You can probably hear the screams from the audience. Lead going to Detroit. Sarah Hippel picking up the first lead jammer in this game, blasting into that pack, taken down to the ground and calls it, holding Gotham to a zero. Oh, the audience are loving this already. 3 points picked up by Detroit. That's a fantastic start for the lower-seeded, lower-ranked team.
They will be delighted with that as a kickoff. These two teams have played each other twice before, but the last time was in 2009. Gotham having won both times. So it'll be interesting to see how this first jam Detroit can build on that.
Jumping into this jam, we're going to see Shortstop for Gotham up against Racer McChaser for Detroit. Racer McChaser trying to go up the outside on the toe stops, but Shortstop racing through that inside line. Lead now in Gotham's favour. Racer McChaser just pushing at the front, managing to dance around the inside. Shortstop really fast and agile, getting cluttered one more time, but picks up a cutting penalty, and this is now a power jam in favour of Racer McChaser.
Not the start that we would have expected to this game.
Not at all. And the audience completely in appreciation of this. I hope you're enjoying this at home. Racer McChaser on that inside line. A fantastic hit to the inside by Knockout. And a good pull back by V Diva. Racer McChaser now back on, facing up. Gotham stuck now back together.
Racer McChaser having to push hard to get even a centimetre of the track. That is some tough defence.
Shortstop is back on track and approaching up against that Detroit three wall. Oh, fantastic footwork. Jumps up that inside line. And there are the first points on the board for Gotham. Shortstop taken down to the inside line. There's a penalty being issued, but it is to Detroit blocker, not to Shortstop. Shortstop still on track, fighting on that second pass. And that's a grand slam for the Gotham Girls Roller Derby jammer. Racer McChaser still pushing against that Gotham wall at the back. This is Shortstop's third scoring pass whilst Racer McChaser's been held up.
Racer McChaser's had to push. That's a good half of the track. They've had to push those blockers, trying to get past.
Just jam comes to an end. 10 points to Racer McChaser, 12 points to shortstop, but Gotham still 1 point behind Detroit. At this point in, we are 3.5 minutes into the action here at the Wftda playoffs in Malmö. On the jam line now, we are going to see Julianne Ricard. And she's up against Space Invader. Space Invader really pushing up at the front, trying to wriggle around those two Detroit blockers. Oh, fantastic work, brilliant work there by Feta Sleeves, and a good pullback on Space Invader. Space Invader blasting through, and it is a forearm penalty. Oh no, not on the jam, not on Julian Ricard, so we are safe for Detroit. Space Invader just getting fielded into the pack.
It is Caffeine who actually picked up that penalty and on their way to the Cheese Balls Bearings penalty box.
Julian Ricard has now broken free. That's taken nearly 50 minutes to break free. Space Invader slides through and there's another 4 points picked up.
I think Space Invader there was trying. Thought, I don't need to get up again, I'll just call the jam.
So our scores currently stand, Gotham 17 points, Detroit on 13. We've just got a bit of quick replay action here. There's that final hit taking Space Invader down, realizing the straddled apex, taking down to the ground and calling that jam. Going into the next jam we're gonna have, that is Swift Justice for Detroit, but up at the front, Misty Maven just pushing through and charging round. That pack's barely moved from where it was. Misty Maven now approaching into that pack and coming up, being held back. Swift Justice playing additional blocker here at the moment.
Misty Maven takes that outside line, dukes across to break free.
Swift Justice having a tough time, a very valuable jammer for Detroit in the first game that they played against Callio Rolling Rainbow. And the helmet cover is off from Swift Justice and the pass has been made over to Cookie Rumble. Cookie Rumble now the active jammer, dancing around the outside line for Detroit.
Misty Maven having to work hard, pushing the Detroit blockers round the apex before calling the jam. And it's an opportunity to talk about Rydell Skates, one of our sponsors. Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in roller skates for over 70 years.
And so you get a fair few sporting Rydell out here today. Do check them out online. 26 points to 13. We are into just 7.5 minutes disappearing. Oh, and it is a lead now once more to Sarah Hibbell for Detroit. Being followed very closely by shortstop. Detroit at the back. Oh! Sarah Hippel went in hard and heavy, and that is a low block penalty. I don't think anybody in the audience was going to disagree that one.
No, that was a big spill. And shortstop them, taking that hit to the floor, but getting out. And one hand down, was able to just carry on picking up the 5 points.
Shortstop now back in a rumbled Detroit pack. They were being recycled back. Gives an easy pass for shortstop. Shortstop now coming around on a third scoring pass. Being held up, big hit thrown in there. Lolly pops them hard.
It does indeed.
Sarah Hippel now back on the track, trying to fight through that Gotham braced wall. V Diva and Sexy Slady at the back really holding fast. But Detroit also very defensive right now. Shortstop having a tough time going around the entire Gotham wall before being caught up by Detroit.
And fast and loose there, trying to give some offense, but that wasn't, trying to break up the wall, but wasn't needed.
Fettersley's picking up a clockwise penalty. That was a pivot for Detroit, who has been very effective, but not necessary. Sarah Hippel bounces around the outside line.
And shortstop with another big spill to the floor on the outside of the straightaway. was back up and just one blocker left out of the pack.
Seconds are running out in this jam. Both jammers now continuing around for a scoring pass, but I don't think they'll have time. Let's have a look and see. Oh, shortstop proving me wrong.
That was a big scoring jam for both teams.
Scores are just being confirmed by the jammer referees and their non-skating official partners, counterparts. 2 points picked up in addition in that final pass, puts Gotham at 17 in that jam.
Detroit on 8, 43 points now, playing 21, and we have just 21 minutes left in this half.
Oh, Space Invader taking a big hit down. Both jammers recycled back. Racer McChaser powering around the outside line. Lee Jammer once more going to Detroit. Space Invader caught up against that inside line. No space to move. Racer McChaser just two Gotham blockers to get past. Manages to dance around Brazilian Nut and Roxy Dallas. Space Invader now broken free, so both jammers in a scoring position. This is Racer McChaser's second scoring pass.
Just one blocker left. Out of the pack completes a scoring pass.
Yeah, this is definitely in Detroit's favour right now. They were down to just the three blockers. A star pass means only a single point picked up by Gotham. And it's now Brazilian Nut who is the jammer for Gotham.
And Racer McChaser has some offense on the Gotham wall ahead of them, but still not able to break through, having to push hard. Offense not able to put any distance between the Gotham blockers.
Oh, outside line opened up. Brazilian not able to sweep around, and there's a 4 point pass for Gotham. Race McChaser taking the advice from the bench to call it. 13-point jam up against 6 points picked up by Gotham.
And that's an opportunity to thank Radar Wheels. WFTDA 27 playoffs are sponsored by the Radar Halo. Experience world-class edging. I think we're seeing some of that on the track right now.
We are indeed. We've got 19 minutes left on the clock in this period. 49 to Gotham, 34 to Detroit. Detroit are fielding Gillian Ricard, and we have Giles jamming for the first time today for Gotham. Giles taken down on that inside line. There is a bit of a pileup happening. Gillian Ricard goes to the outside. Both jammers pull back almost to the jam line, and we start all over again. Giles finds that inside line. Lovely little dance around. Just managing to get around the hips of Kelly Janai. Lead jammer going to Gotham. Gillian Ricard is pushing at the front. But Giles is already back in a scoring position. That Gotham wall just isn't moving.
Centimetre by centimetre, otherwise it would be a stop block. But it is crawling. That is a huge amount of effort Gillian Ricard is having to put in just to go a foot at a time.
Wftda, having lost the penalty, the pivot cover, manages to put it back on. That won't have any impact in the game. Sexy Slady picking the forearms. May do. Big hit to Giles, but that is a low block by Kelly Janai. And Gillian Ricard dancing around the inside of Wftda, manages to break free. Oh, Giles going for that shirt whip. Just denied. Some really good work there by Feta Sleaze. Feta Sleaze is pulling out some brilliant moves for Detroit.
I am having so much fun watching Detroit on the track at the moment.
Well, the score's just 20 points differential. 54 for Gotham, having picked up 5 points in that jam to 34. We've got just over 17 minutes left into this.
And if you look at the statistics, you look at all the expectations, we wouldn't expect to see such a tight gap with, 13 minutes gone in this game. You would have thought Gotham would start taking it on.
With Swift Justice jamming for Detroit. And that, I believe, is Misty Maven. Misty Maven again caught up on that inside line, but that will be a clockwise block issued out to Cookie Rumble, the pivot for Detroit. So this might give Misty Maven space. It does indeed. Detroit taken down to just one blocker on the track. Two blockers now available. Not enough for Swift Justice to break out, and Misty Maven gets a free pass.
Gotham able to completely keep Detroit to the inside line, leaving not just one lane, but two lanes free for Misty Maven there.
Oh, lovely. Just enough glance by Kelly Janai to take Misty Maven out. And a little run back by Irish.
But Misty Maven takes that outside line and is clear of the pack.
Swift Justice having a tough time in this jam. Detroit focusing on that defence. A no pass, no penalty. Means another 4 points picked up by Misty Maven. This is going to be a high scoring jam for Gotham. The star pass has been initiated and successfully completed, but unfortunately Cookie Rumble is still caught up behind and picks up a cutting penalty. This is going to give more space for Misty Maven. We've only got half a minute left remaining in this jam.
And I'm just absolutely hypnotized by the work that the Detroit blockers are there, holding back Misty Maven in a really fast-moving, dynamic way.
They are picking up penalties because of it, and that has given us another 5-point pass for Misty Maven. 24 points so far in this jam. Oh, another pass before the time runs out. That gives us a 29-point jam, Dark Mistress.
Wow, that's the kind of, you know, I think I may have jinxed it. That's the kind of thing I was expecting. And we'd seen that first 13 minutes be really tight and then Gotham come out and pull 29 points in a single jam.
We have a timeout being taken by Detroit.
It is a team timeout presented by 888, who have been protecting Derby since day one. And it's an opportunity also to give a big thank you to Atom Skates, Savant Wheels by Atom. Light, fast, responsive, everything you look for in a wheel. I also prefer them to be round.
Round is useful, but not essential. Yes, Dot Mistress, 29 points in that last jam, but we have only just passed the quarter mark. And as we were saying, Detroit coming out strong and clever.
They really got the momentum from that first jam that really gave them the heart to sort of bring it every single second. And their defense has been incredibly strong. Picking up three lead jammers in the last...
Sorry, they've just turned the lights up, which has really, really helped us out.
So as I was saying, because I got distracted by that tea, Detroit picked up three lead jammers so far and three multi-pass jams, you know, against Gotham's five. And that shows how tight it was in these first sort of seven jams.
Team timeout has now come to its conclusion. We'd like to say thank you to 888 for that timeout. As we said, 14 minutes 49 where the clock has paused. And this is short stop for Gotham. Quick and easy through the middle. Fettersley's not quite able to hold short stop back. Going for the inside line again, breaking apart Fettersley's and Laserbeam.
But that is what happens when you have just two blockers on track. It makes it a much easier job for your jammer to get through.
Oh, we have a cutting penalty issued to Cookie Rumble. Cookie Rumble had the star off their hands, but Fettersley's was busy working on the defense. Cookie Rumble picking up a cutting penalty. Shortstop, another grand slam pass.
And that was a direction of gameplay penalty issued to Gotham there, giving Detroit the blocker advantage on track.
Oh, just enough push there by Fettersley's, taking a short stop now back. Detroit able to get this time now to recoup, get themselves together. And when they are together, they are strong.
And I think what we've seen in these first few minutes is also that you don't need to have that very traditional two walls separated by up to 10 feet.
Oh! That was a low block by Wftda on Cookie Rumble. Wftda sent to the penalty box. Cookie Rumble now having broken free from the pack.
That was a big tumble there.
Gotham Girls Roller Derby have broken that century mark. They are on 102 points, having picked up a 19-point jam.
So if you think about it, in the last two jams, they have just about doubled their score. That's how important these last two jams and that momentum have been. And it is an official timeout. And it's an opportunity. Ooh, that was a quick official timeout.
Very swift.
Yeah.
So Detroit's still on 34 points. Gotham, as we said, on 102 points. Just under 13 minutes left in this period. We're going to see Space Invader up against Racer McChaser. Racer McChaser, very good at picking up lead. Has been awarded lead, but was knocked to the inside line and recycles all the way to the back of the pack. Space Invader now coming through on a scoring pass. Racer McChaser, I'm not sure if they're aware, but Space Invader knocked to that inside line and a good recycle back by Terrorette.
But Racer McChaser now on a scoring pass.
Caught up with Space Invader, but Space Invader now just breaking through, having removed the helmet cover. Points picked up prior to the removal, and it's a misconduct penalty issued on Racer McChaser. So this is going to give lots of space now to Space Invader.
And the full 2 minute jam.
We are 1 minute 10 into it, so this is going to be a good advantage now for Gotham. Space Invader picking up another grand slam.
And that is the second time that Detroit lost the lead due to penalties.
Racer McChaser has now come back onto the track, but Space Invader just being very agile around the outside.
Racer McChaser very willing to go and fight for that inside line to push anybody in their way out of it and to take that inside line. But he's having difficulty getting the Gotham wall to move.
A good knockout and pull back by Irish on Space Invader. This pack is at the front, and that will be penalty issued at the back for blocking out a play to Irish.
Racer McChaser now having to go on toe stops from the straightaway right into the apex, just pushing against people. That's tiring.
It's incredibly tiring, especially when Detroit were taken down to just one block on the track by the end of that jam, which allowed Space Invader an extra pass, 23 points in that jam. Gotham now 1-2-5. Detroit picking up 4 on 38. And we are heading towards the last 10 minutes in this period.
Gotham picked up just around 75 points in the last three jams. And that just shows how, we always say 2 minutes is a long time in roller derby, but I think this game is absolutely proof of that.
Yep, they've also managed to hold Detroit to just 4 points in the last four jams. So wow. Not only effective in scoring, but very effective in the defense as well. This is Wftda jamming for the first time for Gotham, picking up lead jammer, Sarah Hebel. I do believe this is the first time Sarah Hebel hasn't picked up lead jammer, and the star has been passed over to McDonald. But Wftda, beautiful work, picking up another grand slam pass.
And Wftda just makes that look easy. I'll do a little skip.
Detroit again depleted in numbers. That is a penalty to... Oh, it's not a penalty. I do apologise. Duncan Disorderly has issued... No, it has issued that penalty. I believe that might have been a misconduct. So we have no jammer currently on the track for Detroit. And this is going to give Wftda lots of opportunity to expand Gotham's score. 15 points scored so far.
But both teams with just three blockers on track.
Gotham go for the push. Detroit carry on rolling. That pack is stretched out. And the blocking out of play happens.
And that was Feta Slees picking up the blocking out of play.
And Sarah Hebel returning from the penalty box to pick up another penalty. So back into that cheese balls bearings penalty box for Sarah Hebel.
That was a very full cheese balls bearings penalty box in this jam.
It still is pretty full. I'm having a look. I can see Detroit's chairs almost all taken up. And we are taking an official review being called by Detroit.
That's an official review presented by 888, protecting Derby since day one. We were having a debate earlier about when day one was, but I think the conclusion was a long time ago.
Very long time ago. 38 points to Detroit All-Stars, 150 points now for Gotham Girls Roller Derby All-Stars. We have 8 minutes and 38 seconds of play in this period, and it is an official review. We will cut to our head referee, Duncan Disorderly, once the query regarding the official review has been stated. Duck Mistress, so much stuff happening.
It's a half of two halves. So the first 8-7 jams were just so tight, and there was just 20 points between the two teams, and then Gotham kind of woke up, and we've seen 100 points go on the board almost in four jams.
Yeah, we've been looking at since jam
Detroit
five.
Detroit are challenging the cutting call on their jammer.
Thank you, Duncan Disorderly. So Detroit held to just 4 points in the last five jams, whereas Gotham have been pulling up a minimum of four passes for each of those jams as well, all of them barring one being a full 5 point pass as well. So the massive scores that Gotham are pulling up, the 25, the 24 point jams in the past four jams, it's showing on that scoreboard now.
Well, the scoreboard does, you know, when you look at the stats in that way, it really tells you where the momentum is in this game. And those first seven jams, Detroit coming out and taking that first jam, had a huge impact. And I think it took a while for Gotham to maintain that momentum, to bring back that momentum, sorry. And then you can see that multiple passes coming and racking up the scores. And it's also an opportunity for us to talk about S1 helmets. The S1 Lifer helmet is the best fit and the best protection, and that means it's equal to being made for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer.
We're going to cut back now to Duncan Disorderly with the result of that official review.
Detroit jammer was assessed to have cut multiple skaters, therefore the cutting call will stand. Detroit does not retain their official review.
And that's the result there.
I think that sums it up pretty adequately.
Also tells a story. Detroit, they're picking up four jammer penalties so far in this game. Gotham, just the one. I think that also has had a big impact in those multi-pass jams.
As indeed. We are going back into the action, and it is going to be Giles jamming for Gotham. Up that inside line, picking up Lee Jammer fairly swiftly. Sarah Hippel, of course, starting in the cheese ball bearings penalty box. And another nice easy pass for Giles, just bouncing off the inside of Kelly Janai to get that pass. Back in for a second scoring pass. Oh, lots of juking, splits that Detroit wall apart. Sarah Hippel now just throwing her own players in. Lovely work there, using that space created to find the inside line. Giles goes thundering in. Quick spin around, checks with the bench and calls that jam.
Giles there, really willing to take on every blocker individually.
As is necessary. Detroit managing to clear out from the cheese ball bearings penalty box. So we're going to have full raft of blockers on the track. 38 plays, 164, and we have 7 minutes and 20 seconds going into this jam. Misty Maven up against Racer McChaser. Racer McChaser has been very good at pushing to get lead. Gotham have managed to slow them down for the past couple of jams. Racer McChaser finding some space around the outside line. Going up against V Diva. In the meantime, Misty Maven dancing at the back, trying to split that Detroit wall apart, but they are just swarming around.
Racer McChaser still pushing hard up front and was able to get some open space, but the rest of the pack has caught up with her.
Misty Maven still pushing out the back. These Jammers are just plugging away. There's not much more that they can do right now. That pack is stretched out. Oh, a little bit of space comes up. And there is lead going to Misty Maven. 50 seconds before lead is awarded. And a very swift break by Racer McChaser. Only half a lap behind. So Misty Maven goes in, dancing in, takes those hip whips. A single pass for Gotham.
Well, this is the first jam that we've seen it take that long to establish lead jammer, and I think that showed in just having the one pass and how Gotham weren't able to maximise that opportunity.
6 minutes left on the clock, 168 for Gotham, 38 for Detroit, and we are going to see Gillian Rickard up against shortstop. 3 for 3 on blockers for both teams. Shortstop being pushed into that Detroit wall by Gillian Rickard. Shortstop now trying to maximise the space. Goes up that inside line. Lovely work to avoid the brace. Little jump to regain the balance. And lead goes to Gotham. Gillian Rickard taken to the outside. But it is an elbows penalty being issued. But long drawback. Brilliant work by number 7 Brazilian Nuts. Shortstop on a scoring pass, breaking just around the outside line. At the same time, Gillian Rickard breaks through that inside. Shortstop is paused, waiting to see if the box can be cleared. Gillian Rickard slows down as well, not quite sure what to do. That was a good pause there by Shortstop to try and kill as much penalty as possible on Violet Knockout, who is standing in the cheese ball bearings penalty box. And Gotham obviously seeing that the more players they have on track, the more they can wear Detroit out. And I think it has been a wear out rather than a massive change of tactic. Detroit coming out really strong to start off with,
but just weren't able to step it up when Gotham decided to go up a gear. And Gotham are working really hard to preserve their ranking points just by shutting down Detroit and not letting them score at all.
We're going to see Swift Justice up against Space Invader. Space Invader at the back trying to... just testing all those angles and the sides, proximities, finds the outside line, not able to be held back by Terrorettes. But Swift Justice pushing and finding a little bit of space at the front. You say that, you're up against Wftda, who is solid at slowing you down. Wftda and Violet Knockout not quite able to hold back Swift Justice, and this recycle back brings the Jammers in line before Space Invader calls.
But I think the key thing for Detroit, if Gotham's objective is to stop Detroit scoring, then Detroit have to get out and force the jam to be called after just one pass if they're going to keep in touch. So Detroit's picking up just 4 points in that last 9 jams. It just shows that Gotham are really focused on making sure that there is as big a point differential between the two teams as possible.
Yeah, they haven't scored in 5. In the last 5 jams, Gotham have kept them to a 0 point. 38 plays, 173. We're going to see Giles for Gotham up against Sarah Bell for Detroit. Detroit again in the white. Gotham are in the black. That pack is stretched right out. Star has come straight off for Sarah Bell, who passes. A successful pass has gone over, and that is to Feta Sleaze. But at the moment, Giles is on a scoring pass. Detroit just closing in, making shapes around the Gotham Jammer, but Giles pushing through, almost stepping through, oh, nearly, and does pick up a no pass, no penalty. So that is a full scoring pass for Giles. Fettersley's having a tough time after receiving the star. Oh, and Giles with a nice little sneak through, almost makes it, just held up and hindered by Kelly Janai.
But in that scoring pass, Fettersleaze hasn't been able to move the pack forward any further.
I think they've actually moved a little bit back. Gotham doing a very good job of enclosing any space that's been given.
And it's Sarah Hopel who's trying to give some offense there to Fettersleaze, but not able to break that solid wall of black up front.
There's still over 30 seconds left in this jam if Giles wishes it to continue to run. Of course, Giles still lead jam and knocked to the inside line. Quite a heavy hit there, so a call off by Giles, having picked up another 3 points, making a 13-point jam.
get some fresh legs on track. So that is 186 points for Gotham. They're playing 38 for Detroit. 1 minute 39 left to go in this half. And so it's an opportunity for the WFTDA would like to thank the host league, Crime City Rollers, S1, Rydell, Atom Skates, Quad Skate Shop, and Double Threat Skates.
We have Racer McChaser up against Misty Maven. Misty Maven going out to the middle. Racer McChaser going from the in to the middle. Both of them caught up at the back. Space on the inside. Misty Maven finds it. Manages to dance through, picking up Blue Jammer for Gotham. Racer McChaser still pushing. Comes up against V Diva sideways. Penalty being issued too fast and loose, which means that Racer McChaser has broken. Misty Maven still caught up on that scoring pass, picking up 3 points before having to call it. So a good chase down by Racer McChaser, living up to their name there.
And that's going to make a big difference. So in the last nine jams before this jam, Gotham had scored 132 points.
Wow.
It was more than 13 points a jam. Detroit only 4 points. But forcing Gotham to call it off on a scoring pass or on the first scoring pass is going to be really important for Detroit in this second half.
We're into the dying seconds, 25 on the period clock at this point in time. 38 points to Detroit, 189 to Gotham, and a quick Lee Jammer awarded to shortstop, who just got low and kept powering forwards. Oh, Julian Ricard picking up a cutting penalty.
Oh,
thought they'd broken free, just getting that penalty past the pivot line.
I was just getting excited then.
Shortstop now, free reign to pick up some more points. A grand slam of 5 already up high, and Gotham just 6 below the 200 mark.
And that's the kind of score they're going to be looking to go into halftime with, that kind of differential.
Another raft of 5, shortstop now, bringing them up to 199 points. That will be the 2. Some very good recycling. Oh, beautiful recycling there by Julie Ruin, but not quite able to hold shortstop back. Julian Ricard trying to get shortstop out, not quite able to catch, and is now trying to use that broken up Gotham wall to get around. But Gotham very good at slowing down, taking that space.
Just not allowing any space for the jammer to get through, but we have actually finished the period clock now, so it will be halftime at the end of this jam.
4 more points for shortstop on that pass. Julian Ricard yet to make an initial pass. So this is going to definitely give him lots of space. Shortstop, lovely dance, just managing to balance on that inside line for a 5-point pass. And just pushing up in the last 10 seconds, shortstop with a lovely spin around. The points currently scored by shortstop in this game are 83 out of Gotham's 218 points.
Valuable skater.
It's an incredible amount.
And that was a great jam for Gotham. 29 points in that last jam to go into halftime. 218 points, now playing 38 from Detroit.
We've got a few statistics to throw to you. Detroit's points have only been scored by 2 of their jammers. Sarah Hippel picking up 11 points and Racer McChaser with 27.
But in terms of lead jammer, Detroit have had lead jammer 3 times, but they have lost lead once and 3 multipass jams only, whereas Gotham, 14 lead jams, only lost lead once, 11 multipass jams, and that shows... That explains 218 to 38.
It does, and I think you summed it up perfectly, Dark Mistress, at the beginning when you said it was a half of 2 halves. Detroit looking so strong as they came out. They'd already had that first game today, so they've got the lay of the land, as it were, coming out really strong, knowing they're coming up against such a high name and a high seed. And it looked like a really fantastic work. Their workload hasn't reduced. They are still putting in exactly what they were doing in that first quarter. But Gotham managing to lock down. They're now comfortably in this game.
They just kicked it up a gear. I think, you know, they were a bit surprised with the strength and the momentum that Detroit came out with. It took them a few jams, but kicked it up into another Gotham gear and started racing away. And those multi-pass jams are the key.
Okay, we're going to wrap it up here. We're going to take you over to a commercial break. Catch us for the second half in a few minutes. And welcome back. Thank you for watching WFTDA 2017 playoffs here in Malmö. I'm Holly and I'm joined by Dork Mistress. And we are watching and announcing the Gotham Girls All-Stars against Detroit All-Stars. Scores currently 218 points to Gotham, 38 to Detroit. And just to give you a reminder, the top four teams from this tournament will be joining us at the 2017 International WFTDA Championships on November the 3rd to the 5th in the city of Brotherly Love, Philadelphia, live from the Lycos Center. Tickets are on sale now. You can also still get tickets for the feed for this event. Just $16.99 at WFTDA.tv. Money well spent.
You're missing out otherwise on an incredible weekend of action, but also history. First ever 2017 International WFTDA playoffs outside of North America.
Have a look at the Gotham Bees up in the audience. Not that they need to keep too warm. It is in fairly northern Europe, but not too cold up here, so it's pretty balmy.
I think it's also the huge numbers who have come out to be part of this weekend. I believe over 1,000 tickets sold, so there is a big crowd here at every game. They've been here since the first whistle this morning.
And if you are looking to join us, you can join in at WFTDA. You've got hashtag talk number two, WFTDA.
And just a quick reminder that as the game starts, the winner of this game will go on to play on Saturday at 6 p.m. versus either Crime City or Helsinki.
Into the action, Misty Maven dancing up that inside line. Lee Jammer going to Gotham. And Sarah Harper just dancing around. Fast and Loose at the back and Sexiest Lady. Fast and Loose holding down, and that will be a high block to Sarah Harper. So a power jam now going through to Gotham.
And that is the fourth penalty that Sarah Hypeller has picked up in just over one half of this game.
Oh, we've got a cutting penalty being issued to Misty Maven. Misty Maven and V Diva sitting in the penalty box for Gotham at the same time. Sarah Hypeller has been released
from the Cheese Balls Bearings penalty box.
Sarah Hypeller doing a dance at the back, but Gotham holding solid, and now she's trying to push through the middle of that wall. Misty Maven back on track, manages to throw off a little dance around. So Hypel now back in on a scoring pass. Just manages to stay on the inside and the outside line. But the points go first of all to Misty Maven. It's a 5-point pass.
Sarah Hypel getting some offense from Kelly Janai, trying to break up that wall of was four up front from Gotham, but is hit out and recycled.
Recycled all the way back as well, which even though only a short distance is a tough amount to go back against these Gotham blockers. Sarah Hypel trying to get on and slow down Misty Maven. Knocked to the outside line, forces that call off. Detroit picking up a set of 4 points, but Gotham coming away with 10.
So in that first jam, 228 points now to Gotham, 42 to Detroit. Bit different to the start of the first half there.
But not too different to the end. Gotham actually pulling 11 points. The scoreboard's just been updated. So 11 points in that last jam for Gotham. Looking into the next jam, we're going to see Shortstop, who started really low on the outside of that jammer line, up against Racer McChase. So these two have come up against each other a couple of times in this game already. Shortstop picking up lead jammer for Gotham. Race McChaser up against a four wall. Gotham now gone into that four defense. Shortstop on her own, gets a knockout by Cookie Rumble, who pulls back before Detroit go back to that three wall. Shortstop very good though at getting those gaps and finding those spaces, splitting that wall apart.
But Race McChaser has left the pack, forcing the jam to be called. Race McChaser, one of the two jammers from Detroit who's been able to pick up points, picking up 27 points so far in this game from Detroit, belong to Racer McChaser.
Yep, some really good work As you said, not giving us the action that Detroit, or the hope that Detroit gave us at the very beginning, but they are still fighting for these points.
I don't think anybody watching this game is going to think Detroit haven't put everything that they've got on track.
We're going to see Jillian Ricard up against Space Invader. Space Invader plowing through the middle, getting held up by her own team before going into that four wall of Detroit. Some really good work, a good slowdown, and that will be Fetter Sleeves who picks up the clockwise block, allowing Space Invader some space.
Jillian Rockhard still pushing hard at the back of the Gotham wall up front, just as Space Invader jukes past, jumps past, goes, no, I'm getting those points.
Space Invader doing a fantastic job of actually getting around. Jillian Rockhard saw that they were coming through and just managed to get around the wall and the jammer. Beautiful spinning now on the outside for a second scoring pass, Space Invader. Jillian Rockhard still having a tough time.
But Space Invader now stuck behind a tripod of Detroit blockers up front. But unfortunately picking up a penalty, so it is now just three Detroit blockers on track.
Caffeine really low, slowing down Jillian Rockhard. Bit of a hip whip straight into that muddle of the pack, and that sexy slady taking Jillian out on the outside line. Space Invader not to the inside line, but now finding a bit of room. I thought they were going to go for a bit of a run. Space Invader held on that middle of the pack, fast and loose with the offense. But once more, that is Fetter Sleeves, who's a pivot for Detroit in white, doing a wonderful pullback on Space Invader, and once more knocking Space Invader down to the inside. Jillian Rockhard just one blocker to bleed at the front, but Gotham recycles back around. And that three wall, beautiful hit by Fast and Loose. These jammers are just getting 20 feet and being pulled back every time.
Lollipops some hard from Detroit, doing some amazing work, bracing that Detroit wall and hitting out Space Invader, holding Space Invader down at the end of that jam. And I think both jammers will be very pleased to hear that final whistle.
I think they would do indeed. Just a break by Jillian Rockhard before that final whistle. 0 points for Detroit, so they remain on 42. Gotham, 19 points picked up, they're on 252. We've got 24 minutes left in this game.
So that's just three jams in 6 minutes. That's three full-length jams.
Oh, beautiful dance by Misty Maven, swinging around the inside line, picking up the lead jammer very swiftly. Swift justice, however, once again stuck almost in that scrum of Gotham players. That three wall really sandwiching around Swift justice. Misty Maven knocked to the outside, but only very briefly.
That was great work from Swift justice, turning the Gotham wall around to give her that space to jump out.
Misty Maven just with a final push round, calling that jam and picking up the 4 points for Gotham.
But in these first few jams, Gotham have really taken that opportunity to stop Detroit from scoring any points possible. And they're just 4 points for Detroit in these first four jams.
Detroit held to a very low number at the very end of the second half as well, I believe. It was only 4 points in, I think it was
nine jams.
Yeah. My word.
So clear strategy there from Gotham in how they want to see this game come to a conclusion.
Sarah Heupel and shortstop, the two jammers on track. Shortstop bouncing from the outside line to the inside, picking up the lead jammer. Sarah Heupel having a tough time, but pulls a low block penalty on Sexy Slady. So Gotham just down to the three blockers. Shortstop, however, already on a full scoring pass, having picked up the 4 points. Sarah Heupel staying in front, and shortstop pulls that just before Sarah Heupel can get in and score points. Lovely timing work there by Gotham.
Absolutely. And it's an opportunity to give a shout out to Powerdyne. Powerdyne changed the game again with their newly redesigned Arius Platinum plate. Arius Platinum, performance redefined, and quite pretty and shiny.
Very pretty and shiny. Under 22 minutes left in this game. Gotham in the black, Detroit in the white. Detroit are fielding Racer McChaser.
Oh,
just one to beat. That is hands in the air from Brazilian Nutt and Lee Jammer going to Racer McChaser. But Racer McChaser being chased down herself by Giles. That pack starts to pick up some pace. Giles manages to overtake Racer McChaser. It's a swing and a swing for the two Jammers. Oh, lovely work by Giles stepping around that inside line.
But an interesting choice there from Racer McChaser not to call the jam, deciding to let it run long.
Giles now back in on his second scoring pass. Detroit managing to close down and do the recycle back. Racer McChase is still on the first scoring pass. Sandwich work there with a low block being issued to McDonald. As Racer McChase knocked to the inside line, Gotham doing some very good set him up and knock him down work.
But they're having to work hard to take Racer to McChaser to that inside line. She's brushing off really hard hits.
Giles, in the meantime, some really good work, making sure that there's bursts of speed at the right time. Oh, not quite able to get past. But I do believe it is a low block penalty issued there. Yes, it is to Julie Ruin. So Giles now attempting that inside line one more time, and this time successfully so.
Racer McChaser getting offense from her entire team of blockers, but still not able to get out, and that jam comes to an end.
3 points picked up by Detroit. Racer McChaser, I can only assume, was told to go in and run, try and pick up as many points as possible for Detroit, but it has backfired a little bit. Gotham picking up 19.
I can see the strategy they were trying to do, but I think actually just the Gotham were too strong for that play to work.
Completely. Interestingly enough, Detroit still have got their two timeouts and their official review for this off. Gotham haven't used any of their timeouts so far and still have an official review for this half as well. Misty Maven, just one more blocker to beat, manages to do so, getting around Laser Beam. Lee Jammer going to Gotham. And at the back, it's Gillian Ricard up against Fast and Loose and Sexy Slady. Fetus Lee's coming in to try and provide some offensive play, but is picks up a penalty themselves.
But Misty Raven, for the second pass, finds that wide open outside lane, takes it, and barely any time or momentum lost in the pack.
I think Detroit have had trouble just then flicking between the offensive and the defensive play, especially when they're losing key players from their pack. Down to just the two blockers who are unable to stop Misty Maven. They do look like they're coming back to provide some offensive play now for Gillian Ricard, but Misty Maven's already back around, so they switch to defensive play. Misty Maven, however, finding the outside line so favoured.
And Gillian Ricard being held back. Sexy Slady and V Diva just being a powerhouse of a wall.
Good knockout. I believe that it is indeed Fetus Sleaze, who is just having a sterling game. Fetus Lees with a knockout and the pullback on Misty Maven. V-Diva goes in to provide some distraction,
which is successful as Misty Raven clears the outside line again. Third or fourth scoring pass now, taking that outside line.
It's a fifth scoring pass. 25 points already picked up, clocked up by Misty Maven. Gotham have broken the triple century. 304 currently to 45, and that will be another grand slam. Misty Maven having a look.
I think Laser Beam there wasn't quite able to close down that inside line to stop Misty Maven coming through.
Just waiting for some confirmation from the scoreboard. Clock is 17 minutes and 25 seconds. Detroit being held to that 45 points. Gotham picking up 35 points in that jam. That's 10 points less than Detroit have scored all game. 314 points to Gotham with that 35-point jam by Misty Maven. Now that's going to be going up into the top 10, I believe, of the Wftda jam scored. It's certainly going to be in the top 20. It's going to be high up there. I'm having a look at our producer. He's going to have a quick check for me. In the meantime, Shortstop is up against Swift Justice. Swift Justice just pushing against that wall. We do have some offensive play by Ulrich. Shortstop dancing around that wall. That wall rotates with shortstop. Shortstop benefits. Goes round the outside of the entire pack and picks up Lee Jammer.
Swift Justice there again with that trick, trying to pivot the Gotham wall round at the front. Managed to get through but fell and was reabsorbed into
so
the pack.
So unfortunate when that happens. Shortstop in the meantime doing a fast and tasty work of splitting apart the three wall and just racing up the inside line that's been created by the defensive play of Gotham.
And our producer shows us actually to be in the top 10, you really need to be scoring above 40 points.
Whoa.
In a jam.
Things got tough really quick. So close, but no cigars. Swift Justice on the pullback on shortstop. Shortstop is playing the time game. That pack starts to reverse. Swift Justice, a helmet cover in her hand, just feeds shortstop into her three wall.
That was a lovely piece of work by Swift Justice there. Just going, no, I want you to go here.
They have managed to slow down the progress of shortstop, who'd already picked up 10 points in this jam. However, the time is in Gotham's hands because they're quite happy to delay the time being so far ahead. Shortstop does manage to push through on that inside line.
That's McDonald for Detroit going to the box, and that is now the fourth Detroit player who is on five penalties or more. And I think that may start to play in the last 15 minutes of this game.
Which we are fast approaching.
Indeed, and it's a chance to make sure that you've filled out your bracket predictions for the 2017 WFTDA Playoffs Bracket Challenge. Just as we enter into a 888 timeout. 888 helmets, pads, wrist guards, we've got you covered. Well, obviously not everywhere because we still get bruises.
It's Detroit who have taken this 888 timeout. Detroit in the white, Gotham in the black. Gotham 329 points, Detroit on 45, and we've paused the clock just under the 15 minutes remaining.
And as we were saying, it's important that you have gone on to WFTDA.tv, onto the website even, to make sure that you've filled out your brackets, because we are seeing big games this weekend. There's going to be some upsets. Last weekend there was some very big upsets. If you fill out the bracket, you've got an opportunity to win great prizes from WFTDA.tv. S1 helmets, radar wheels, and you need to get your predictions in for Dallas now, so visit the website.
Also, whilst you're visiting the website, you can check out the store at WFTDA.com. You can get your WFTDA track jackets, clipboards, exclusive t-shirts and more there. Let us know what you look like in your merch. Send us a tweet at WFTDA Live. Also, hashtag talk the number 2 WFTDA. We're keeping an eye on it. If we're not reading things out, I do apologise. It's because the action is just so good here. A quick Lee Jammer going to Space Invader. But a fight certainly being put up by Sarah Heipel. Space Invader knocked to that inside line. Really good work there by Terrorettes. Recycle happening. And the forced call off, but 3 points collected by Gotham in the process, holding Sarah Heipel to a zero.
I mean, Detroit have only scored 7 points in this second half of the game, whereas Gotham have been able to put a lot more on the board.
Quite a few more.
And it is all about protecting rankings for Gotham at this stage. So they want to see a bigger point differential as they can achieve in the next 14 minutes.
They've certainly got the 14 minutes to do it. Oh, and a back block penalty issued to Racer McChaser at the very start of that jam. Gives a massive opportunity for Giles to exceed those points indeed and extend that lead. Giles picking up Lee Jammer but not to the inside line. That looked like a very tentative run back by Cookie Rumble. Almost a Scooby-Doo villain-esque run.
Gotham being very successful at breaking up any attempt from Detroit to put together a wall to hold back Giles.
But Giles does break through. Giles now coming around on a scoring pass. Swoop from the outside to the middle of that three wall. Down on her knees, but back up, and that is a full 5-point pass. Racer McChaser, however, has now broken free. So Detroit managing to hold Gotham to two passes, one initial and one scoring pass in that penalty, in the penalty box sponsored by Cheeseball Bearings.
But Giles is out and completes another scoring pass just as Racer McChaser is hit out to the inside and recycled. Ooh, and that was a big hit.
It's a couple of big hits, a bit of a ping pong ball almost going through, pinballing for Racer McChaser. Gotham recycling themselves and setting themselves back really quickly as Giles now makes her way through.
Racer McChaser pushing hard on turn two.
Out of play issued. And Racer McChaser has now broken free. But some good work there by Giles, leaping over and staying on her toe stops on that inside line. 19 point jam.
Yeah, 351 points, now playing 45 with just 12 minutes left to go in this game. And it's just a reminder that the next game, which will be on at 6 p.m. Central European time, is Stockholm versus Terminal City.
Should be another full action-packed game to watch. Stick with us, though, for the next just under 12 minutes. Swift Justice currently on the track up against Misty Maven. These two have fought it out a few times already. Misty Maven managing to maintain balance, picking up the lead jammer on the inside line. Swift Justice finding the outside line. Oh, caught a glancing blow by V Diva.
Brushes it off, but that was hard work. That was a big hit from V Diva.
And managing to hold Misty Maven to just 2 points. You can hear from the crowd, that's a victory in itself for Detroit.
They'll be very happy.
Indeed, Swift Justice back at her bench, massive smile on her face. Gotham 353 points, Detroit now 45, and we've got 11 minutes left in this game.
And it's an opportunity to thank Triple Eight, protecting Derby since day one, and they have new helmets that protect against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection system.
Oh, Julian Ricard with a bit of space, knocked to the outside, but picks up very quickly.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Hit out. Sorry, I'm catching up with the action there. That was exciting. So yeah. Julian Ricard breaks out of the pack first, but picks up. No pass, no penalty. Does not pick up lead jammer. Space Invader sees that, calls the jam just as Julian Ricard approaches the rear of the pack on a scoring pass.
And we've got a definite time kill there by Gotham. They waited all the way through until we had Julian Ricard at the back of the pack before that jam was called by Space Invader.
But Gotham still succeeding in their strategy of closing down Detroit to no scores. 7 points in the last 11 jams for Detroit, 124 for Gotham.
Wow, that is a big differential. 106 points have been scored by Shortstop in this game so far. Shortstop now back on the jammer line for Gotham, up against Sarah Heupel. Both jammers pushed into it, middle of the blockers there rather than the back. Bit of space for Shortstop, enough space for her to just spin around. Lead jammer going to Shortstop.
For a minute there, the pack looked more like a rugby scrum than an actual derby pack.
There was just a big melee of blockers.
But now we're in a more traditional 3-1, two separated walls out. And that's no difficulty for Shortstop to get out and complete that scoring pass.
Detroit now come back in for the offensive play, and V Diva pulling a cutting penalty on Sarah Heupel means that Shortstop is now in a power jam situation. Sarah Heupel now on six penalties. We're going into under 9 minutes left. There's less than a minute left in this jam as Shortstop approaches around for a third scoring pass. Gotham coming in for the offense, managed to break them out. Oh, lovely work by Fetter Sleaze. Fetter Sleaze managing to knock Shortstop to the inside and forcing that call off. Brilliant work there by the Detroit pivot. So 14 points picked up by Shortstop. Brings Gotham to 367 points. 45 for Detroit still. We have 18 minutes and 10 seconds left in this period.
I think Gotham will be looking to break the 400 points in this game. And we have an official timeout, which is an opportunity for the WFTDA and Crime City Rollers to thank these companies for their generous support of this weekend's event. Double Cross Clothing, Steaks, Edgy Veggie, Oatly, Steaks, again, they must do
they really doubly want to sponsor.
Good. Chaya Skates and Molan's Falafel, which are truly delicious.
Jumping back now into the action, the clock just above 8 seconds. And we're going to see Giles for Gotham in a power start. Sarah Hypel going for a full rotation. Lee Jammer has gone to Giles. Looks a bit confused at seeing Sarah Hypel ahead, but Sarah Hypel is now on her initial pass. Giles with a lovely toe stop run around the outside line, picking up a set of 4 points.
It's Perisher from Detroit trying to provide some offense to get Sarah Hypel through. But Giles just skates around the outside.
Helmet is in hand. That pass has now happened. Terrorettes is the active jammer for Detroit. And a knockout and recycle back on Giles by Sarah Hypel.
And that was also Irish. Doing some great work, really slowing down Giles and trying to eke every second out.
It was a brief second I thought Giles was going to go to the inside, but some really good balance work by the Gotham jammer. Goes through for the arms as Gotham are now recycling. Terrorettes still with the star in hand. This is still the initial pass for Detroit. Giles is on a fourth scoring pass.
And it's Sarah Hypel who's gone back to brace up that wall, holding back Giles, and is now going back in to give some offense.
That was some really good work on the toe stop. I think fraction of an inch staying on that inside line by Giles. This is going to be the fourth scoring pass. Now, these haven't been easy scoring passes, so Giles is using a lot of energy to manage to maintain that agility and that carefulness as well. There's the call off from Giles, very cleverly done. Knocked to the outside, 21 points in total, bringing Gotham's score to 389 points.
And just an opportunity to thank S1 Helmets. Durable, functional, stable. The S1 Pro knee pads are built for roller derby and I think have been very useful today. We've seen some big spills.
We've seen some fantastic action all the way through today here at the WFTDA playoffs in Malmö, and particularly in this game, Gotham up against Detroit. We're into the last 5.5 minutes on the period clock. Racer McChaser, who has been such a high-scoring jammer for Detroit, their highest-scoring jammer in this game, is on the jammer, is with the star, pushing up against that wall. But Misty Maven, who is just so agile, dancing around the outside line, picking up her feet, and now through for a scoring pass.
Racer McChaser still pushing hard up front, but is still just on turn one. And now the apex of her initial pass.
Misty Maven managing to make space where there is none, getting her shoulders and her hips in into gaps that you would not dream are possible. Oh, lovely spin around, manages to jump off of the final hit. Lovely pass there by Misty Maven of Gotham.
But that is the 14th lead jammer for Gotham in this period. Detroit only once.
Oh, sorry, that was a very quick slowdown on Misty Maven.
Again, both jammers having significant difficulty getting past the defense of each team, but Misty Maven makes it out.
Racer McChaser eyes up Misty Maven, but decides to carry on going her own game. Knocks to the inside line by Sexy Slady. No recycle back. And now it's Laser Beam trying to pull Misty Maven back. Laser Beam going in for the offensive play, just trying to shunt Gotham around.
Racer McChaser trying to take advantage of that big sort of pack. Brouhaha couldn't break free, but Misty Maven is out, completing another 5-point grand slam.
Oh, beautiful spin around the outside line. Team timeout, sponsored by 888, being taken by Detroit All-Stars. This is their final team timeout. Tell me a bit more about 888.
So 888, protecting Derby since day one. I think the whole message is that they've been there to support us right from the get-go. They've got us covered.
Gotham have now broken that 400-point marker. They're on 409 points with a 20-point pass there in the previous jam. Detroit still on 45. They've been stuck there for quite some time.
It's been, I think, 12 or 13 jams that they've only been able to score 7 points. And in fact, it's only two jams this period that Detroit have scored 7 points in 15 jams.
So some incredible defensive play by Gotham, able to rack up the points at the same time. We've got under 3.5 minutes left as we go back into the action. We're going to see Space Invader for Gotham in the black up against Gillian Ricard for Detroit.
Gillian Ricard has been a real joy to watch in this game. It's really stood out for me. I mean, both, you know, obviously alongside Racy McChaser with the highest penalties, but oh, Lee! Obviously, I gave the gave us some motivation there. Lead jammer for Detroit.
Yep. Brilliant work on that inside line. Gillian Ricard managing to just find enough pace to get past their Gotham blockers. Now on a scoring pass while Space Invader is still hooked up in that wall on the initial pass. Space Invader, chasing down Gillian Ricard, who managed to find the inside line. And that is a grand slam for Detroit. The crowd is celebrating as if it's a win.
Well, it is only the second time this period that Detroit have got lead jammer, and with such style.
Cutting penalty issued to Gillian Ricard. And 5 points picked up by Space Invader. They are 5 for 5 each now for both jammers. Space Invader, of course, on this power jam. Only jammer eligible to score right now, and score she does. That's another grand slam pass for Space Invader.
Well, this does make a two-minute jammer, and of the two lead jams that Detroit have had, they've now lost this one.
Beautiful work there. Going straight into the side surf for Space Invader on that inside line, showing her back some sensible play.
But Gillian Ricard is back on track and back into the Gotham wall up front on turn three.
Gillian Ricard just one scoring pass behind Space Invader as it currently stands. We've got less than 20 seconds left in this jam. Daryl doing a very good job of controlling the slow Gotham wall, and indeed a knockout, and that's going to be a long drag back.
Half the track, all the way back to the straightaway between turns 2 and 3.
And not enough time for any more benefit going in, but the crowd are loving the fact that Detroit have managed to put some more points on the scoreboard. 9 points for Detroit in that jam, 18 points for Gotham. Gotham now 427, but Detroit back up to 54.
Just a quick chance to thank Atom Skates. New backpacks by Atom are available now. Can carry everything you need in one place. I always forget something, though.
That did have to be a quick one, because we are now less than a minute on the period clock. We're going to see Swift Justice up against Shortstop. Shortstop picking up Lee Jammer from running around the outside line. Swift Justice up against V Diva and Sexy Slady, who work so well together. Gotham now back up to the four defensive blockers as Shortstop is just left to her own devices.
Shortstop, the highest scoring jammer for Gotham in this game, now on 125 points of those 432 belong to Shortstop.
That's a fairly decent whack of points, and they are growing by the second. Shortstop another 5 points. Swift Justice has helmet cover in hand, but is still pushing up against that Gotham wall. Fettersleeves goes in to provide some offensive play, but Detroit are unable to slow down Shortstop. who picks up another grand slam for Gotham. Oh, beautiful breakthrough. Almost Kelly Janai making space on the inside line, but V Diva closing it up straight away.
But the period clock has ended.
It has indeed. Shortstop is still going. We have time left on the jammer clock. Jam clock says 45 seconds. Shortstop currently on a 20-point jam. And Detroit down in players.
Just two blockers on track. And they were at separate ends of the pack at
they
that point. So weren't going to be able to hold back Shortstop.
They are desperately trying to do everything they can to defend and play offense at the same time. Shortstop calls the jam to an end with no time left on the period clock. 30 points picked up in that jam. Unofficial score at the moment. We will confirm it as soon as it is confirmed. But 4:57 playing 54. Dog Mistress, what does that do?
So on the unofficial, let's see if we can work it out, WFTDA rankings, it looks as though that score will see Detroit drop four places, but Gotham will maintain their position, their ranking of third.
And that score has indeed been confirmed. 457 points Gotham finishing this game up against Detroit with 54. Detroit came out so strong in the first quarter, seemed to tire a little in the second quarter, and had a really, really tough time in the second half.
And I think you can see that in the number of penalties that were picked up, particularly in the second period by Detroit. They have a number of skaters on five or six penalties, three on five, two on six. So, and I think it just shows with that sort of, you know, energy, the tiredness that had taken out of them in that first quarter. So for Detroit, it is 16 points in the second period. So just 16 of those 54 points came in the last 30 minutes, but 228 for Gotham in that same time.
It's an incredible amount to put up in a half.
But Detroit there, clearly the fan favourite out of today's game, getting a huge ovation from the crowd as they skate round. But that was still an amazing game of skill and technique.
Yes.
I just remember Swift Justice pivoting around a impenetrable Gotham wall to free up that inside line and get out. That's something I want to go back and sort of watch and try and test.
You'll have to buy your pass and check out the archives. You can still get passes for the remainder of this week. $16.99. And you can check out today Stockholm Roller Derby up against Terminal City Roller Girls, which will be the next game up. And then later at 8 p.m. Central European time, we're going to see Crime City Rollers facing off against Helsinki Roller Derby.
I've been Dork Mistress.
I've been Holly. I think we're going to cut to an interview. So stay tuned and watch the interview with Gotham.
Hi there, I'm Casey Bomber, and I'm here with Benita Applebaum of Gotham Girls. Gotham, what a heck of a game.
Yay!
You guys came in here, you're ready to just get in here,
yes,
play it hard,
yeah,
and make your mark nice and deep.
Yeah, exactly.
What a game. So Benita, you've been with Gotham since 2011.
Yes.
Since their first championship in their run of championships.
Yes, I was with the league in 2011. I've been with the All-Stars since 13.
Okay, yeah. So, you know, you've seen a good arc with Gotham.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so 2011, Gotham, you know, Oli was kind of the evil empire.
Yeah.
And Gotham comes in, and Gotham girls were this underdog, and everybody was cheering for you with so much love. And then suddenly Gotham's the evil empire.
Yes!
Right? So
yeah.
In the last couple of years, when you have not taken the Hydra,
mm-hmm,
where would you say Gotham is categorized now?
There's still a little evil empire involved.
Okay.
But I think people recognize that, you know, it was a lot of hard work. I think
right.
After a long run, people thought like, oh, we don't care, or like, you know, whatever. But it's really a lot of hard work, and I think we gained a little bit of fans in not winning, but still working really hard throughout the whole game,
right,
playing through every jam.
Do you think that it takes a little bit of pressure off of you all to not have yourself regarded in that way?
No, I mean, I think most of the pressure is what we put on ourselves to, you know,
sense.
every season our goal is to get that Hydra, so we always have that pressure. And there's other records that
all
we're
right.
trying to keep.
Sure, yes. And I've noticed, you know, you're playing on a different jammer rotation than
we
we've
are.
Seen with you
mm-hmm.
all recently. Yep. So with that four rotation, with the V-Diva thrown in there for fun.
Yes, for a little flair.
What kind of adjustments, you know, as a team made to adapt to this new rotation that we're
yeah.
seeing?
Yeah, I mean, I think we always try to talk to our jammers about what works for them. And then we try to, you know, think about strategies that help our jammers, right? Obviously, they need to score the points, so whatever we can do as blockers and as a team to sort of help that is what we try to do. But I think, you know, they talk about the hive mind, so I think it's a really sort of organic strategy that we sort of put together.
Yeah, well, I think that it's safe to say that it worked very well in
yes.
this game. Congratulations on your win.
Thank you.
We'll see you again tomorrow.
Yep, 6 p.m.
Against the winner of today's 8 p.m. game. So yeah. Tune in at 6 p.m. to see how Gotham fares tomorrow. Thank you, Vanita.
Thank you. Hi, New York.